demonstrations, which started in June, repeatedly became violent clashes under the instigation of individuals with ulterior motives. Some radicals surrounded Hong Kong police headquarters. They disrupted government agencies. They ransacked the Legislative Council building. On June 9th, demonstrators started to protest against the proposed amendments. In the wee hours of June 10th, well-organized radical protesters started attacking the Legco building, blocking roads, and assaulting police officers. 8 policemen were injured. On June 12th, an illegal rally started around Admiralty. Well-organized protesters assaulted officers with bricks, homemade spears, injuring 22 police officers. Some radical members stayed around the Legco building until midnight, assaulting officers with even patrol bombs. Though police exercised restraint, the protesters continually assaulted their line of defense and forced police to use appropriate force to disperse demonstrators. HKSAR Chief Executive Carrie Lam announced on June 15th that the HKSAR government will suspend amending the ordinances concerning the transfer of fugitive offenders.
保安局局长今日会致函立法会主席。 收回就條例草案恢復二讀辯論的預告。換句話講，立法會大會就住處理條例草案的工作會暫停，直至我哋完成溝通解說同埋聆聽意見為止。On
June 21st, even after the HKSAR government announced that it had halted the amendments, extremist protesters surrounded police headquarters and wreaked havoc. On June 26, a few fanatics instigated demonstrators to storm police headquarters for the second time.
A小撮
极端激进分子在7月1号晚上用暴力冲击立法会大楼，并且大肆的进行破坏，场面触目惊心。他们为了一己的政治目的扰乱香港秩序，行为是超出
香港人的底线。
他于是为暴徒公然破坏法治，并企图践踏立法会以至香港特区和国家的尊严。我哋建制派议员一致作出最严厉的谴责。示威者嘅暴力行为已经远远超越和平表达诉求嘅底线，警方表示极度遗憾，并予以最严厉谴责。
暴力唔会带俾香港任何嘅
结果或者达不到任何的事情的，希望大家同心协力谴责暴力。中方维护国家主权安全和发展利益的决心坚定不移，维护香港繁荣稳定的决心坚定不移，坚决反对外部势力干预的态度也坚定不移。